I'm Yolanda Gampp, and you're watching Save the Cake. Today I'm gonna meet Grace, and she is hoping to make a cake for her baby who is turning one.
So my name's Grace. I run a food and lifestyle blog, and I'm an accountant, but I am like a horrible baker.
Let's do this.
Nice to meet you.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm great.
Good.
These are my Christmas cupcakes.
Okay.
And I was trying to make a Christmas tree.
That's more like a Christmas shrub.
You made these for Christmas? So who did you make the cupcakes for?
I made them for a friend's potluck. They said it looked like Grinch peanut.
Oh.
I feel like that's not a compliment.
So I have a baby for his 1-year-old birthday. I really want to bake him a cake. So I want to do a smash cake and I want to make it myself.
I feel like a lot of moms feel like that, even if they're not bakers. There's something about especially the first birthday that you want to participate.
And I thought a carnival themed smash cake would be really, really cute.
Oh, I'm excited. Will I get to use the fondant iron?
The fondant iron?
Like the thing that looks like an iron and you...
Oh, you need a smoother. Yes, we will use a smoother. A little bit. I'm excited. But first, I'm gonna need you to make my Italian meringue buttercream. It's one of my favorite core recipes, but it happens to be the most difficult recipe I make.
My reputation as a baker is I can't follow instructions. I'm a really big klutz and I'm a little bit messy.
I'll be around, but I'm not gonna help you. You're going to follow instructions. See, there's only 8 steps. It's not even that intimidating. And yeah, so why don't you start reading? I'm not gonna say studying. You can start reading and we'll get some ingredients for you.
All right, I'm ready to do this. Let's go. Step number 1. I'm freaking out on the inside, but she's still in the room. So obviously I can't like look like I'm scared. I can't look like that fazed me.
Oh, do I need to measure the sugar? It actually looks pretty good right now.
She's stirring the sugar and the water, which she should really just leave it alone.
Please don't burn. While the sugar syrup is heating, put the egg whites in a bowl of a stand mixer fitted with a whisk attachment.
So I'm currently trying to whip the meringue until it's soft peaks. Oh shoot! Is it supposed to boil and bubble like this?
Oh, I can't hear you right now.
Does this look right?
I'm just gonna finish this show. I'll be right there.
I guess I'm not gonna get any help here.
Okay, immediately remove from the heat, and with the mixer running, pour the syrup into the egg whites in a very thin stream.
My buttercream is steaming. Obviously, the recipe book's not telling me that my mixture should be steaming, but it is telling me to add butter.
She's starting to add her butter right away, and the recipe clearly states to wait till your sugar is at 230 degrees. So I'm hoping this works out for her.
Okay, I'm done.
Okay, let's see what you got.
Is that sugar on the pages of my cake book?
How'd it go? Okay. You did a good job. It's slightly soft, but for your first try, it's good.
Oh, yay!
Miraculously, it came together.
Mm. Tastes like buttercream.
Okay, Grace, you nailed the Italian meringue buttercream. So now it's time to build a cake.
Okay.
Okay, so because it's carnival themed, I thought fun colored cakes would be fun. So the first thing we're gonna do is layer these cakes into 2. I've already leveled them, taken off the caramelization, but we're gonna cut each one into 2 layers.
I've seen people use like cake levelers.
I know what you're gonna say.
Levelers work great in sponge cake, but I find when a cake gets denser, they just don't always work well. And essentially it's like you're letting something do the work for you.
Yeah, never say cake leveler in front of Yolanda. It's like a swear word.
So here's my best friend, handle him with care. And what you wanna do is measure the height of your cake and then make a mark all the way around the cake at the halfway point.
The layer that she's cutting right now has a bit of a hump inside because she was tilting her knife up without realizing. You always want to use the middle of the blade. If you can see the end clearly out the other side, especially on a small cake, you're more likely to be going straight than to be dipping in or dipping up. So right now I'm going to teach her how to just trim that away and patch it onto the other layer.
She's looking nice. And for this one, sometimes you can pick up the little scraps. Just MacGyver. You know what I mean?
Does this generation still know who MacGyver is?
Okay, ready? We're gonna move on to yellow cake.
Okay.
So Grace, the next step and very important step is to simple syrup the cakes. Do you know what simple syrup is?
It is 50% sugar, 50% water. Good for you, Grace. You passed the first test. Well, isn't it the second test? Buttercream was the first test. So while the syrup is soaking in, the next thing we're gonna do is create the secret chamber.
So we want a chamber in this cake that we're gonna fill with a sweet surprise.
So we're gonna use a circle cutter, and I'm teaching Grace how to use a ruler and make sure that we place our circle cutter right in the center of each layer before we cut down. I'm also gonna teach her how you can use, you know, you can cut one chamber out of one layer and then use that layer as a guide to cut the rest of the layers.
It's the Leaning Tower of cake. We have everything we need and we're gonna fill and stack this cake.
Okay. So the first thing you do is lay down a layer of cake, place the same circle cutter in the middle to protect the chamber, and then dollop your buttercream on and spread it. Then you remove the cutter, place on the next layer, and repeat.
I can feel Yolanda like over my shoulder being like, keep it flat, keep it flat.
So think about your spatula as a flat surface and use that whole flat surface instead of doing this.
Okay. I just have the temptation to like start scraping with the side of the spatula thingy.
The dredging. No. I can't. Ah! So just drop it.
Okay.
Like just dollop.
Okay.
Don't spread at this point.
I feel like a kid just learning new swear words all the time, like leveler, dredging.
I'm thinking I don't want to do that again and get yelled at.
I think it's actually a little bit harder than it looks because when you're watching cake videos on YouTube and on Instagram, like usually it's like, oh, and done, and next layer, and done.
You know what I feel like? We need to have a ghost moment. You're gonna be Demi Moore and I'm gonna be Patrick Swayze, okay? So I just wanna help you with the, like, see how that feels? You wanna use the flat side rather than doing this.
I've never seen Ghost, so I don't know what she's talking about. Ghost is not in my generation, guys.
How has she not seen Ghost? I can practically recite this movie.
That is not what ghosting means in this generation.
We built this beautiful cake with a chamber. The chamber needs a surprise inside. So these are just chocolate chips that are like candy coated. And then you can just sort of ladle in the chips until it's level with this top layer.
She's pouring the mini candy coated chocolate chips into the chamber. Some are falling on the top of the cake, but that's okay. We'll sweep them in after. Now Grace just needs to spread buttercream on top of that layer and add the final layer of cake.
We can go straight into a crumb coat and chill. This is super important when you're cake decorating.
Is there a tip when we're doing the crumb coat to stop yourself from, is it dredging?
It doesn't matter if there's dredging in the crumb coat. The entire purpose is to lock the crumbs. This is the only time dredging is acceptable. The whole crumb coat is basically a dredge. So now we're gonna ice the cake. And the difference between icing and crumb coating is now we want to get on enough buttercream to have a nice white smooth surface.
I feel like Grace is trying to be super, super careful while icing to the point that she's going very slowly.
This is actually harder than it looks. It's hard to keep the icing like on the spatula and then like stick it there.
So I've taught her how to hold her spatula, how to pick up the buttercream and ice it along the outside. And she's slowly making her way around the whole cake.
So if you look at like the straight line of the spatula, you can sort of start to take away some of the excess buttercream that's here.
So because this cake is tall, this is essentially what they call like a double barrel cake, meaning it's twice the height of a regular cake. We're gonna use a bench scraper. What you do is you line up this straight edge with the side of the cake, and then you wanna have it on a bit of an angle, and this way all of the excess buttercream gathers up against the bench scraper and scrapes it away.
This cake weighs more than my baby. When you go to the grocery store and you pick up a cake, it is definitely not this heavy.
So Grace, this is fondant. It's like a sugar plasticine, so you can mold it, you can roll it, and cut nice red stripes. And then we can line them up on your cake once we're finished icing it. I like to just gently have my arm under it and then flip it onto the board. There you go!
That was definitely a holding your breath while baking moment.
There you go.
When I think of fondant, I just think of like ironing fondant.
I will let you use my fondant iron. For no other reason than you just want to know what it feels like. It doesn't really play a role here. There, you are the fondant ironer.
Ironing fondant is definitely not like ironing your clothes.
First thing we want to do is cut one straight edge from one side, and then from there we can measure.
I am cutting my own stripes, and for some reason, every time I start to cut, my stripes always end up with like this little squiggle in them.
So what happens if you make a mistake in the fondant?
What do you mean by a mistake? Okay, so you just won't use that stripe. The good news is I think we're gonna have more than enough stripes.
Fondant is not forgiving.
Because stripes are such a simple, classic pattern. The problem is if they go awry, it's super noticeable. So what you wanna do is you pick up the first stripe, and I often like to use a ruler, and you always wanna touch the stripe just at the top. Okay, and you kind of come in, line it up with the base cake board, and then just run your finger over it very gently to press it. I've shown her how to place the first three stripes and how to trim them at the top of the cake. She has to do the rest on her own. I'm gonna walk away. Don't worry.
I've never worked with fondant before. It's not my friend. Fondant is not my friend. She's really ghosting me right now.
All right, Yolanda, I'm done.
Awesome!
Cake looks great, but I think we need a bit of a party on top. So I've brought so many fun things to put on Grace's cake. Really tall lollipops, swirly lollipops, rock candy, caramel corn, every amazing thing you would find at a carnival.
There is a lot of candy. Somebody's gonna get a toothache, and it is not my baby.
Who's it gonna be?
This is really where Grace gets to make this cake her own.
She can just be creative and use her imagination. I have nothing to do with this.
I want the top of the cake to look like candies are just exploding out of the cake. It's gonna look very whimsical and very colorful with just a lot of layers of candy and popcorn. My son is gonna love this. He loves red and he loves animals. He loves candy. And so this cake is right up his alley. It's gonna be delicious.
Yay! It looks so amazing. Her son is gonna love this.
After this experience, I'm feeling much more confident making cakes. If I see something on the internet, I know that maybe this weekend I can go home and make it.
It's so amazing. I can't believe it. It's so colorful. It's amazing work. I love it.
What?
No. That's so cool.
Grace, I am so proud of you. You did so well. This cake is just picture perfect.
I'm very impressed with how the cake turned out, and I'm so happy he loved it.
I have to go now and save some more cakes. I hear someone calling. Another day, another cake saved. Ditto, Grace. Ditto. So guys, that was Save the Cake. We worked really hard on this show and I've been saving it to share it with you on YouTube. I wanna know if you think I was too hard on Grace. Was I? Just leave a comment below and let me know. I'm teaching a live baking tutorial this holiday season where I can teach you how to make a giant ornament cake. I answer all your questions along the way. And even if you can't do it with me live, maybe you live in another exotic part of the world, you will have access to the recording forever, so you can do it at a more suitable time. There's a link below to shop for this and so many other awesome Bake You Happy classes. Check it out. And in the meantime, if you want more cake, click here.